yes, after months of waiting, my Bronco is finally here, but it's not the right one that I ordered. Ford sent me the wrong one. Good morning and welcome back to the channel. Hope you guys are having a great day. I'm starting off right with the Bang Pina Colada. Great drink. If you haven't tried it, you're missing out. Anyway, we're about to hop in the 450 and take it over to Enchain Designs. Oh, I got a package. Taking the 450 over to the shop because they need it for something. I'm not sure what, but something. I have a dog food and this one says auto parts on it. So I'm excited for that one. Whoa, 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 whoa. Okay, it almost fell. You know what? I'm pretty sure this is the new air filter for the ZR1. Many, many mods happening to many vehicles and we will get to that shortly. Oh yeah, the massive F450. Now this truck is super cool. I really like it, but I just don't need it right now until after the Viper is twin turboed. Then we'll have to trailer both cars, the ZR1 and the Viper, to track events. Until then, I don't really need the dually. So every $1 spent on EnchainDesigns.com gets you one entry to win this truck plus 10 grand cash. Life-changing stuff. Don't miss out. Click that link down below. Get some cool merch. Get entered, like this shirt right here, if you like my ZR1. Get some cool merch and win this truck plus 10 grand. We try to do really cool giveaways. You know, we've done Vipers, Lambos, Corvettes, other trucks, but I feel like this one might be the most badass yet. It's freaking, I mean, everywhere you go, you get compliments on it. People say that's a badass rig. We're at the shop and we're gonna pick up the Gen 1 Raptor because there is only 2 days left to win that truck for you guys. Now, when you enter for this truck here, you automatically get entered for the other one. So you don't have to select whatever. So if you don't win the Raptor, you're automatically entered for this truck. So don't worry, you get, you know, you're entered for both. For the same price. Sorry, I'm not doing a good job at explaining it. This truck goes on for the next 35 days. If you get entered within the next 2 days, you get entered for both the Raptor and this truck. I'll tell you what, we've had a lot of vehicles in here, even some pretty big trucks, the 6x6, you know, all that good stuff, but nothing has ever made our 10,000 square foot building look small until this sucker was in here. My God, it is freaking massive, but it looks so good. And you can win this truck plus 10 grand cash, all for getting some cool merch. You can get a Bakery AK-47 shirt. That one comes in black now. You can get a Tropical M4 shirt. You can get some great detailing stuff for your car. And the feedback that we get on this stuff, especially the wheel and soot cleaner, is incredible because we didn't just go to like a cheap brand and say, hey, let's put our logo on it and sell it. Like, we actually had a chemical company formulate good stuff. And that's why I've had so many people DM me and email me and say, like, this is the best stuff they have ever had, by far our best seller. And it really works because we had problems with our Corvettes getting so dirty. You got to give that stuff a try. The glass cleaner, you guys are loving this as well. The classic detail spray, and then the new car wash concentrate, which you mix a little bit of this in with water and it will last you a long time. Anything and everything on the website counts to win the F450 and your last day to win the Raptor, which, by the way, winning the Raptor does not disqualify you from winning the F450. So it's literally just an extra vehicle thrown in. It only helps you, and you get entered for both right now. So it is the best time to enter because there is only, like, I think a day or two left while that truck is included for free. Every $1 spent equals one entry to win both trucks. Yes, after months of waiting, my new Bronco is finally here, except it's not the one I ordered. Basically, my Ford Bronco is very, very late, and because it is so late, and mine and many other people's are late, Ford said, well, we're gonna start lending these out so that people can at least borrow one. That's why I have this one. So let me give you a quick tour and I will explain a lot more. I know you guys have all seen like Bronco tours and all that good stuff, but I wanna show you the interior and kind of the length of it here. If I reach over, I can reach over on the other side pretty far. But I think it's pretty neat because we happen to have a Wrangler Rubicon, my Wrangler, my JL right here. And you can kind of see the difference on the inside. Number one, Jeep is much more narrow. I barely have to lean. In fact, I can pretty much sit here as I would normally sit driving and reach over and touch the other side. So they might look similar, but the Wrangler is definitely a lot more narrow, which might be good if you want just an off-roader. The interior in general is kind of similar, but you do notice the size. If you want the more roomy daily driver, I think the Bronco is going to be better for you. Now, I will say, though, there's going to be a lot of comparisons with the Jeep and the Bronco, but if you want the real off-roader,
Jeep is the way to go. Solid front gives you a lot more flexibility with modifications and, you know, just in general better.
Yeah, the Jeep interior, very nice with the JL, huge upgrade. And you can see where your four-wheel drive selector is. I kind of like this old school setup better than the dials and everything. That's just me though. The big difference here for the Jeep is the doors have a big frame on it, which I think is actually better, because if the Bronco had the frame on it, I know that not having the frame makes it easier to take off and store, but if it had the frame on the Bronco, if they didn't go with this design, I would have mine right now and they wouldn't be having so many issues with the roof. And I think that, you know, the big thing is, like, look, when you open the door, it has no frame, so the window has to come down, like a Corvette or a Lambo, whatever. A lot of vehicles have that, but the problem is that it has to come down so far, it can't do it quick enough. And I suspect that windows on Broncos will break. Get a real good look at that, and then we'll walk over right to here, and we'll see what you guys think. Which one do you like better? Man, I gotta say, I think the Bronco is a little bit more, I do like that it's more roomy, and I think it looks a little bit more, I think for the car that you're gonna drive every day, I think the Bronco has the advantage, but for the off-roader, I like the Jeep a lot. I really do like this interior. You fire it up. It's got great graphics on it, on the screen here, and then on the center screen. One thing I love about the Bronco, I'm not sure if the new Jeeps have this yet, but it has the wireless Apple CarPlay. Now, I don't think it's gonna work because my phone is not out here. Rich is coming, there he is.
Fever.
What's up?
New Bronco,
new
huh?
Bronco.
Man, I tell you, I never know what I'm gonna see when I come
here. That's true.
This looks really cool though.
Yeah, I like it. What do you think of the inside?
It kind of reminds me like of a Jeep or something.
Oh, it's Jeep-like.
Yeah.
Very Jeep-like.
Yeah, so, but it, you know, I mean, it looks like it'd be a lot of fun. I love this canvas top.
I don't know about this. Look at this. This is like a hand. Look how flimsy this is.
That's for me when you go like super fast and I have to hold on and I squeeze it so
hard. You need that in the ZR1.
My knuckles turn white. Yeah, I definitely want one of those in the ZR1.
I'll tell you what else was surprising and really nice actually was the price. $38,000, well, about $39,000 there. But I think that's pretty good for what you get. Again, this one doesn't have all the bells and whistles. It comes with a lot and it'll be good for what most people are going to do with it. So I think it's a pretty good price. It's right on par with the Wrangler. And again, as a daily, I think it does have its definite advantages over the Jeep, although the Jeep, I think, does have the advantage off-road. So it really comes down to what you want. Already know, new test vehicle, we gotta do it. Let's go manual mode and downshift here. What gear are we in? I can't even see what gear we're in. All right, let's get down into, where do we wanna be here? Third gear, maybe second gear. Second gear, and go! Okay! It's actually pretty sprightly, pretty quick. You're gonna hear me complain a little bit about Ford in this video, but it's not my dealer's fault or any other dealer's fault. Unfortunately, it's a manufacturer problem, and my dealership, Whitmore, has been great, and the Bronco specialist there, Diana, she's been great. Everything about the experience has been great on the dealer side. My only complaints are with the brand side, and again, we'll get into that here right now. Overall, I'm impressed. I think it's great that Ford came out with a Bronco that really does look like a modern version of the original. Ford is doing a great thing with the Bronco, and this is, once again, the Big Bend Bronco. So if you had the Wildtrak or if you had the Sasquatch package on there, it would look a lot cooler. I know it kind of looks a little bit tame right now with the street tires and it's not very high and you're comparing it to a nice JL on 38s, but you can make these look really good. And I think mine being the two-door is going to be very cool because I kind of like the really small off-roader look, and it will be a great compare. I mean, it's gonna be awesome when we finally get my actual Bronco, because we'll have a two-door Bronco, two-door JL. We can put them up against each other head-to-head on the trails and see which one is better and go in with it. You know, they're both gonna be mine, so I don't have to like try to make the company look good. I don't care. I'll beat the crap out of both of them, and whichever one does better will be the undisputed winner. A lot of YouTubers say they're gonna get this car, that car, and they never do.
And I always do it. Like, if I make the decision to say, like, hey, I'm getting this car, I will do it. And there is Rich firing up the Z06. But I also don't drag things out. Like, I don't make 37 uploads about what my next car is going to be. I generally try to, you know, announce it and then get it very soon. The ACR only took a while because I just couldn't find one. You know, I wanted a snakeskin car. There's only 31 of them. So, yeah, that one took some time. And I did make a few uploads about it. But I try to get stuff as quickly as I can because I love cars and trucks, and I'm a 12-year-old. Like, I see something I want it now, and it kills me to wait. I hate the buildup and the hype. I just want the vehicle. When Ford announced the Bronco, I was like, yes, I want one, super cool, you know, just my type of thing. I love the whole 90s era, very nostalgic for me. You know, I grew up in that time with those vehicles, and the new Bronco looks super cool. I want one. So I put a deposit down to get me on the list right away at Whitmore Ford. And I said, you know, as soon as the ordering process opens up, I want in. I was trying to get a very early car for two reasons. Obviously, from a YouTube standpoint, like, if I can get a new hot vehicle early, that helps my job. That's not Ford's problem, it does help me. And also, I genuinely am excited and I want it early. Love and life, Rich is, he's great. Rich is awesome. Great neighbor, best neighbor ever. Point is, I put my order in a long time ago and I had to be one of the first to do it because I was always like ready to go, number one on the list. And again, I'm not suggesting that Ford should get me an early car. I don't care. I wanted one really as early as I could. Like, forget about the whole YouTube thing, but I was, every step of the way, I was doing my part to be as early as possible, number one in the line for everything. And I put my order in, like, I picked out everything in one day and said, yes, you know, put it into the factory and get me my truck. So it got pushed back from May to June, which, you know, whatever, just a couple of weeks. I wasn't too worried about it. And then June rolls around and I didn't really hear much. And then it got pushed back to July. And then July rolled around, it got pushed back to August. And keep in mind, this is not my delivery date. This is the build date. So my truck hasn't, forget about getting it delivered, has not even been built yet. August rolls around and finally they give me another build date for like August, like middle of August. And it looks like they're actually gonna build it. And they do. So now we're pretty recent rolls around and they say, well, actually bad news. We're having a big problem with the roofs on the hard top roof for the Bronco. So if you ordered a hard top, you're going to be delayed. Well, guess who ordered a hard top? That would be me. And I guess it's just bad luck. Hard top roofs are leaking water really bad, which, you know, I think Doug DeMuro actually called that like happening. He called it happening before it even happened. And me looking at one myself now up close, I can totally see where they went wrong. I mean, big time with the window. I think it's a disaster, but I don't even know if that's where it's leaking, but I think that's gonna be a problem for them if that isn't the problem now. So my truck did get built at some point in August and it's been sitting in a parking lot at Ford ever since. So the chip shortage is not an issue. I know that there are lots of manufacturer shortages going on, but that's not even the issue right now. The truck is sitting there waiting for a new roof and I guess it's gonna be put with the hard top on it. And, the soft top is what it's gonna get, even though I ordered the hard top, so I'm not even gonna get the one I wanted. Driving that Bronco on the highway, which I do a lot of highway driving, it was really loud, and that's why I wanted the hard top, because I've driven the soft top Wrangler, and that's why I got a hard top one, because I prefer it. Now, the soft top is easier to take off, but I don't really find myself doing it that often, so I didn't care. So I did want the hard top. Ford's gonna give me a soft top, which, whatever, I can't really complain. Still waiting to this day on my Bronco. So it's been like, it should have been delivered about 3 months ago, and I'm going on month four, and I have no idea either. Like, I have no updates, I have no clue. Nobody at my dealer has any clue when my Bronco is gonna be delivered, and as far as I know, it's sitting there in the parking lot. Now, for me, and I wanna say this without sounding I don't want it to come off the wrong way, but for me, it's not the biggest deal because I'm very lucky that my job is literally to drive cars and buy cars. So I have other vehicles and other fun ones. I have a Viper, a Corvette, a TRX. So like, to me, it's not the end of the world that my Bronco isn't here on time. Yeah, it kind of sucks for my job because it would have been really nice to get the early videos out, but that's not Ford's problem. So I don't, you know, I can't complain about that. For the average person who is like an enthusiast, and maybe they had like a Bronco as a kid, or they liked Broncos as a kid, and this one comes out and they get really excited about it. Ordering a new car for people that aren't, that don't do this for a living, that's a really big deal. Like, they order a new car, they get excited. Not many people do order one from the dealership new. Most people just kind of go to, you know, 80% of the population goes to the lot because they're not car people. A car to them is like a toaster. It's an appliance. But for car people, especially with an enthusiast type of vehicle like the Bronco, this is a really big deal for people to order a car. What if they had plans like to sell their car and they had financing plans and other things that they were going to do, and now their truck is 4 months late, a third of a year with no updates? I still don't have it yet, so it might be half a year till I get my Bronco. A lot of people are mad, by the way. My dealer has gotten a lot of complaints, as well as a lot of other Ford people I talk to at dealerships. They're like, yeah, people are not happy about the Bronco. We've got tons of people waiting. And again, I understand they don't want to put out a bad product. Like, yes, I would prefer if my Bronco's roof keeps the water out. That would be, I'm totally on board for that. Give me some updates, at least communicate a little bit better. Give me an idea of what's going on here. And I think people wouldn't be quite as upset, you know, because things happen and you don't want to put out a roof that can't keep the rain out. But you also want to make sure that your people that spent money with you, a lot of money with you, are in the loop. So that's my update on the Bronco. I didn't lie to you guys about anything. I ordered it when I said I did. I was supposed to get a very early car. Again, we're over 4 months late now for mine, but you know, it is what it is. You can't do anything about it. And you know, I was going to actually give up, because when I looked at that orange Bronco at that other dealer, I was gonna just try to find one and say, well, you know, some people got theirs, let me try to find one and I'll forget about mine. Ford finally emailed me, this was back in like early August, and they said, hey, we're finally gonna build yours. So I was like, okay, well, if they're gonna build it, there's no point in me getting one because mine will be here soon. And lo and behold, mine finally got built, and now it's sitting in the parking lot because of the roof thing. So it just sucks. So I've always intended to get a Bronco very soon. I'm trying, but it has not worked out. Luck has not been in my favor at all on this one. But I think the Bronco is a good truck. I really like it. I'm enjoying driving this one. The good news is, I'm assuming eventually I will have mine at some point. I hope y'all enjoyed this upload. Again, don't forget our F450 giveaway is live right now, and you can win the Raptor too, which, an important note, the Raptor doesn't disqualify you from winning the 450. So it doesn't disqualify you. So if you're waiting to enter, now is the best time, because you only have 48 hours left to win the Raptor. And again, you get entered for both automatically, and winning the Raptor doesn't mean you can't win the 450. So it's literally a free truck, which is why I think we try to do something different with our giveaways. It's literally a free truck that doesn't affect you in any negative way at all from winning the big prize, the 450. So check out the website, inchaindesigns.com, link down below. Every $1 spent equals an entry for both trucks, one entry for each, and that's it. So if you enjoyed, give it a big thumbs up. Take care. Have a great night. I'll see you in the next one. Dude, what are you doing?
Watching SpongeBob.
Bro, you're wasting time. You need to get on inchaindesigns.com right now so you can win that F450 Platinum.
I can win that F450 Platinum?
Yeah, you can win that F450 Platinum.
I can win that F450 Platinum.
That F450 Platinum. And $10,000.
Remember, inchaindesigns.com, every $1 spent is an entry.